Time to rewind back to 1998 for one of my favourite TV shows. I used to love watching this in the 90s, The Big Breakfast.
Trudging to It's Like That, just round the house. A big train of cameras, sound men, just trudging. Just to see Matt Mills trudge. Anyway, welcome to the show. It is Friday.
Is it? Yeah!
So that's good news. I'm Johnny Bond. This is, of course,
Denise Van Outen.
Your host. Your hostess with the mostest. Sorry.
He says with his hand.
Yeah, I know. It did. It sort of instinctively it went to your cup shape, didn't it?
It's November the 20th.
Cup. There we go. Yes, Friday the 20th. Fantastic stuff. And we're doing Children in Need tonight, right,
Yes,
Dan?
We are. Very excited.
Very,
are you all going to watch?
No.
Yeah. We'll talk about that in the talking point. Eric, it's Friday. Let's all celebrate the fifth day of the week with a big crew hug. Come on.
Yeah, come on.
Come on. No, crew, I said, not family. Is Denise in there somewhere?
I'm here, yeah.
I can feel her, but I can't see her.
Okay, back. Watch him, Denise, because sometimes in those situations they can start to orgy.
They can
suddenly start to orgy at will.
I don't know who that was, but somebody's got big hands.
Yeah, they're quite handy with them. Okay.
Okay, so here's
what's coming up on today's Friday show. Here we go.
At 7:10, Rory Bremner's final chance to make a good impression. We've won last week to midnight.
He's been fantastic all week. One of the best Roots of Midnight's we've had. It's great to have these prestige guests doing things like that. Let's big it up. Big it up. May have a pun target. Big it up. May have a pun target. Okay. At 7:15, we bring you the fastest growing bathroom sport in America. Which
of course
which means lavatory in America. Doesn't it? Mm-hmm.
That's right.
It's a lavatory sport.
And then at 7:20, we'll learn about the chemistry of Christmas from Dr. Roger Highfield.
Yeah. Two findings about Christmas. That's a very interesting item. I was reading through it earlier this morning. It looks like it's going to be a humdinger of a swinger. Plus, we've got Emmerdale star Melandra Burrows.
Yeah.
She's down from the popular TV show Emmerdale Farm. And,
It's Emmerdale. You stop saying Emmerdale Farm.
She's from Emmerdale Farm.
It's cool and trendy now, and it's just called Emmerdale.
She's down from the farm. That's my favourite.
She's down from the Dales.
She's down from the Dales. My favourite farming show.
And okay. From Dales to Dale Winton to Johnny Bourne.
To me, to my hair look like a loaf of bread this morning? Yes. No, because Vicky Sturdy Girl was looking at my hair this morning because she accompanies me in makeup, as you know, and she said it looks like a loaf of bread. In shape, like that. In shape, like that.
Do you know why? Do you know why? Because we need the bread.
We need the bread, the dough. You need the dough.
We do. And from bread to dough.
Bread, dough. Dough, re, mi, fa, so, la, ti, news.
It's Phil Gale. Good morning. These are the main stories on Friday, the 20th of November. A warning over new designer drugs that kill. Paper hits back over Prince Harry's story. And Fergie manages to get into the music business. Two new potentially lethal designer drugs are flooding clubs across Britain. Three people are known to have died after taking one with the street name Flatliners. Criminals are producing the drugs called 4-MTA and DOB in backstreet laboratories like this in South London. DOB, street name Golden Eagle, is said to be 33 times as potent as ecstasy. Les Fiander of the National Criminal Intelligence Service says that users don't know what they're buying.
But the bottom line is, we don't know what's in these drugs a lot of the time, or more importantly, users don't necessarily know what is in the drug.
The Mirror newspaper has hit back at the royal family over its coverage of an injury to Prince Harry. Editor Piers Morgan has refused to apologise for the front page story about a minor sports injury sustained by the Prince. The paper's accused Buckingham Palace of trying to bully the press. And we've just heard that the Prince of Wales is to make a formal complaint to the Press Complaints Commission. A judge in America has confirmed that Louise Woodward must face a civil trial over the death of baby Matthew Epen. The former British au pair was found guilty of manslaughter last year and may be liable for punitive damages. Palestinians have been celebrating in the West Bank after the Israeli government ordered the first withdrawal of troops for nearly 2 years. It's the first phase of last month's peace deal struck in America. Now the Palestinians must clamp down on terrorists in order to keep up their end of the bargain. Television chiefs have rung the changes for News at 10 and its famous bongs. From January, ITN's flagship programme will be no more. New scheduling means that there'll be news programmes on ITV at 6:30 and 11 o'clock at night. The Duchess of York's talents know no bounds. After trying advertising, sitcoms and chat shows, Fergie's moving into the world of rock and roll management. She's just signed up London band Reflektor, hoping that their career can be as successful as hers. Here's the sport. Liverpool have emerged as the new favourites to sign Mark Bosnich. The Aston Villa keeper has reportedly been tempted by an offer of £10 million in wages over 5 years. The deal would snatch Bosnich from Alex Ferguson, who wanted him to replace Peter Schmeichel. Steve McManaman is choosing between staying at Anfield or a move to foreign shores. It's been confirmed that 14 clubs are interested in the midfielder, whose Anfield contract expires at the end of the season. Amongst the big guns after him are Spanish giants Real Madrid. Here's the way the weather looks. Temperatures should range from 7 Celsius in London to 11 in Belfast. Rain is likely in Scotland and northwestern regions. It should be dry everywhere else. This morning, expect rain in the north and west, and the sun will only make a brief appearance in eastern regions. After lunch, that rain will spread to western regions, whilst the southeast will see some sun. Here's the 5-day forecast. Northern areas will have a wet week with sun on Sunday and Wednesday. Central regions will be cloudy all week with rain on Sunday and Tuesday. And for the south, some sun tomorrow, but cloudy all week with rain on Tuesday and Wednesday. That's the Big Breakfast News at 7:06. Back to Johnny and Denise.
Thanks, Phil.
How are you, Phil, this morning?
I'm very well, very well. You all sound very frisky there. It's Friday. Frisky Friday.
We're being very frisky, Phil.
Very frisky.
So do you have plans for the weekend, Phil?
Well, I have plans for the weekend, yeah. Friends having a birthday party tomorrow and might go out for a slight noggin tonight after work.
A noggin?
A what?
A noggin or so.
A noggin, you say?
A noggin.
Oh. And will you be pledging lots of money to children in need to watch us sing tonight?
Will I? Yes, probably. Yes.
Good.
Why not? It's a good cause.
It is a good cause, Phil.
Oh.
OK, Phil, well, we look forward to having your support. Phil Gale, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Phil.
Speaking of support, Mike back.
Johnny, will you stop doing this?
No, I really
have. Let me just explain what happened. We had a rehearsal, camera rehearsal yesterday for Children in Need at the Television Centre, and Johnny picks me up in the middle of the song, and in front of everybody, we're on a microphone, so there's loads of people there who's going, oh, my back! After picking me up.
Oh, no, well, really, it has really
so
hurt
upset.
It. It was nothing to do with your weight, it's to do with the fact that when you... Viewers, if you're lifting anything heavy today...
What do you mean, there you go, lifting anything heavy?
No, but you know, you weigh, what, 7.5 stone, 8 stone?
9.
But what about... No, I weigh just over 8 stone.
Sort of rich from a man who's just had a date with
Louise
Woodbury.
Which is normal for my height. normal for my height.
And, yeah, I know it is. No, look, Dan, no one would deny you have got a dynamite figure. Am I wrong?
Oh, God.
If loving your body is wrong, I don't want to be
thank
right.
Thank you very much. You can all feel it later.
Okay.
But that's not the point.
But the point is, and when I caught you, yeah, I was bent over like that, and that's bad. You should always have a straight back, no matter what you're lifting. Even if it's a little weight, you know, I'm not as young as I used to be. I don't do much sport at all anymore due to my knee injury, and now I've got a back injury as well. That's me out, isn't it? It's gone.
But you will be
even
okay.
Maybe the sexy thing.
But you will be all right for tonight's performance.
I hope so, but I hope it's not going to affect the sexy thing.
But is there anything I can do to help?
Well, yes, there is. And Sonny's got the equipment.
What a boom!
Okay, so we are on tonight. We're on about 10 to 9.
That's right, 10 to 9 tonight. We're going to be singing.
But and
recreating Kylie and Jason.
Excellent. Yeah, okay. And how are we feeling about it? I feel quite excited.
Well, I'm really excited. I'm looking forward to it.
I still can't, you know, even contemplate listening to my voice. When I've listened to playbacks and things of it, I still find it really embarrassing.
Why?
I don't know.
But you sound like Pavarotti.
sound like someone walking across gravel.
No, you don't. He sounds really
good. But also, the other thing...
But also, big excitement. Big you excitement. Have to get your back better because tell them your news.
I'm interviewing Madonna today.
Frozen!
Yeah, exactly. I'm interviewing Madonna today and what a hero of all of us.
Yeah.
And I'm doing that a little bit later today, so I'm actually quite nervous.
Is she going to take it higher?
I hope so. But if you have any questions for Madonna, now's your last chance. Please, you can email them into bigbreakfast.channel4.com or you can fax me them on 01819 85 all the twos. I'm not going to give you no Ben. It's all right, I've done that. 0181. But I admire you keenness, boy. 01819 85 all the twos for any questions, and then I'll ask Madonna. Because what I'm trying to do is.
So when will we actually get to see this on air on Channel 4?
It's just for personal use.
So you're just friends with Madonna and you thought you'd pop along and have a chat with her and tape it.
Ben, why is Ben moving a lavatory around? But anyway, if you've got any questions, 01819 85 all twos or bigbreakfast.channel4.com. Any questions, Madonna, and I shall try and ask them. So I'm trying to avoid the thing where, you know, when people interview these super famous people, you always think, just ask him a few normal questions.
The questions that the viewers want to know the answers.
You've become almost synonymous with the word reinvention.
Do you consciously
reinvent yourself, or does it just happen? Do you control your image? Does it control you? Those are rubbishy questions. But I want to ask things like, "What's your favourite pudding?" I want to really take it down. Yeah. Really, just skim the surface and hopefully reveal more.
Does she
more
cry when she goes to the dentist?
Exactly right.
Diamond tooth.
Exactly right. That's another good question. I'll ask, do you cry at dentists?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll ask you that.
When he gets his big drill out.
When he gets out his
big... Does she get scared when he gets his big drill out and gives her a filling?
Okay, you're turning on Ron for Christmas lights.
Yeah, that's right. You're meeting Madonna and I'm turning on the Ron for Christmas lights.
But you are keeping it real. I've erred from the path of realness.
No, I'm looking forward to it, actually. I'm going with lots of girlfriends.
Have you got a speech worked out?
I need to work out a speech. I don't know what to say.
Will we start with, hello, Romford?
I shall do that, and I'm going to bulldog for you as well.
Yeah, but hello, Romford, UK.
Hello, Romford, UK.
Yeah, hello, Romford, UK. Give it the big rock and roll start.
Okay. And then I'm going to count down, not from 10, I'm going to count down from 100.
100. Well, can we just kind of look at how flyaway Dan's hair is today. You ready for this? Look at this. Look.
Oh. That's because I've just stepped out of the salon.
Salon Selective. Do you know, talking from Salon Selective to someone who's selecting.
I can't believe I did that.
To someone who's selecting tonight's telly.
Ah.
Yes.
And it's the last day. We're going to say a final farewell to
Rory. Rory, what's the story, Rory?
Hi, my name is Bill Clinton. I'm not allowed out a lot these days, so. Most days I just stay in and watch television, and that's my route to midnight.
Friday, 6 o'clock, it's another fix of The Simpsons. Comedy.
Is everything all right?
Well, 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 if it isn't little Jimmy Pearson. Class of 71, I believe.
Good evening, Principal Skinner.
Pearson, get this woman a glass of water immediately, and tuck in your shirt.
Yes, sir.
Nearly 30 and still working as a busboy. That standardized testing never lies.
On through the week we go. And Friday evening, it's that time again. Children in need.
Peter.
Mm. 9 o'clock, Channel 4, Friends, still going strong. Still one of the best of the American sitcoms. Great characters and good lines, and they mix the two together really, really well. So that's Friends, 9 o'clock, Channel 4.
I'm telling you, you're going to be dancing at my wedding before you're dancing at theirs.
Yeah, well, I don't dance at weddings.
Why not?
Because weddings are a great place to meet women, and when I dance, I look like this.
So that's it. That's it for another year. Join us. We'll be knackered by midnight on Friday. But we'll get there, and so will you. Enjoy your television this week.
Oh, Johnny, will you stop hamming it up?
Really hurt my back.
Just a bad back. Just because he lifted me yesterday.
Dan, can you get that coffee for me? I can't do it.
Only if you say get it, you know you want to.
Get it, you know you want to.
Oh, fine.
Thanks, Dan.
I know you want me, Phil.
Okay, listen, we've got our family here, Dan.
We have.
They are the Bailey family from Morecambe.
Yeah. They've planned a routine look. They're all hands this morning.
They are, aren't they?
So, now last night, Bob and Joanna, I've been told that you you went to see the celebrity screening of Bulworth on last night. At the
Bulworth? Bulworth.
Bulworth.
Bulworth. Warren Beatty.
Yeah. You look rather like Warren Beatty.
I know. Yeah.
It's uncanny.
He's apparently got the fastest fingers in Hollywood. Apparently, when he dials on a phone, you can't actually see his fingers move. So quick. That's one of his party tricks. I'm not saying anything.
London Film Festival. Yeah. So how was it? Was it good?
I really enjoyed it. Yeah. It's very surprisingly funny.
Yeah.
Yeah. Really good. He's a senator who organises his own death. And decides to keep it real and starts telling the truth about
Keep it real.
Did you meet him?
No.
No, he wasn't there. No,
but who was there?
He wasn't there.
He wasn't there.
He sent He was meant to turn up, I can tell you now, Joanna.
He sent a filmed apology.
He did.
Oh, he sent a filmed apology, did he? Well, how about we did that one morning, didn't we? For 2 hours. Did we?
So who did you see? Who did you spot?
We saw Angela, didn't we?
Angela Griffin, who used to be Fiona in Coronation Street.
Oh, that's good.
Just on the left there.
There she is. There.
So you quite literally just saw her. You didn't even see her.
You could sell that to the papers for
a fortune. This is the one where she's actually up in
We are old friends.
Yeah.
Okay, what did Emily and Rosie do last night?
To see Charlotte's Web.
Oh, one of my favourite films when I was a child. The Injustice of Charlotte's Web.
So this is the theatre production of Charlotte's Web?
Yeah. The children's theatre.
The Polka Theatre.
Yeah, the Polka.
Did you enjoy it?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So,
did you get back later?
12 grand.
What time did you get back?
About half ten.
Do you know,
In the morning.
I haven't been out that late for ages. I really have. Have you bought that for us to have a look at?
Program,
yeah. Oh, fantastic. Yeah. So would you recommend it?
For small children.
Okay, fantastic. Right. It is a lovely story, Charlotte's Web. It's a lovely book, it's a lovely cartoon, and it's evidently a lovely theatrical production.
Yeah. Okay, now it's your last day with us today. Have you had a good week?
Someone play the spider.
Yeah, the humans play the animals. So someone plays a pig, someone plays a goose, someone plays a spider.
Oh, look, it's all signed, look.
Yeah.
By members of the audience. Okay. Emily, and Rosie, thank you very much. Thank you very much to the family. It's been great having you. Okay, then, let's get this show cracking. Okay. Right now, this is Channel 4. You're watching The Big Breakfast. We're going to really get the show off now with some adverts.
Whoever you're buying for this Christmas, our price have the perfect gift. You'll find Mariah Carey's album Ones on CD for only $12.99. It includes 13 of her biggest hits and 5 brand new tracks. Gifts for all sorts at our price.
Where can I get a mobile phone without having to sign a contract? Can I get a mobile phone without monthly bills? How can I make sure I don't spend too much on calls?
With the Vodafone Pay As You Talk package from Tandy, you'll get a choice of mobile phones, a voucher for your first 60 days on the network, calls timed by the second, and an off-peak rate from just 5 pence per minute.
Vodafone at Tandy. You've got questions, we've got answers.
Welcome back to The Big Breakfast. Are we all right?
Yeah!
Let's bring you in real leisurely this morning. Okay, now, a British television exclusive. Whatever you're doing, stop now. What I'm about to say and show you will change the way you spend a great deal of your day. Do you need to stand that close, Grant? Because your nads are almost on my knee.
Again.
Well, they are. Nice place to rest them. Denise Van Outen, please reveal to the nation the most exciting thing ever seen on British television.
But before we do that, Grant, you can come close to me if you want.
OK, here we go. Don, he'll take that seriously.
OK, are you ready? Oh, no. Actually, you ready?
Yep.
3, 2, 1.
Three, two...
Yay!
There we go. Yes, it's toilet tee-off time with this toilet golf set. It's new from the States. Not available.
It's a golf set?
Yeah, not available in this country until next year. Let's take a look at the equipment. You've got the putter, which is 100% waterproof, lightweight plastic, and it's resistant to staining. Probably quite good for breaking it up. Okay, there we go.
And
we've
got, Johnny!
We've got a ball lightweight sphere. This is manufactured for accurate putting and flotation. It can float within the loop. Which is nice. And we've got the putting green, which is specifically designed to assure maximum piddle, poop and putting performance.
Marvellous.
Okay.
Can you test it for me? Yeah. I don't know anything about
it. Okay, then you're going to have to hold the seat at the back there.
I'll hold that. I'll support that.
Okay, hang on a second.
So what are you going to do? What's the swirly?
What's the swirly?
Yeah, how does that work?
Okay. What, you want me to hit it around the rim at the top of the toilet?
This is somebody talking...
Oh, no, this is rubbish. What do you do? Well, you get it like that, and you have to hit it round the rim there.
Yeah.
I think American rims might be very, very different. Okay, wait a second, I'm getting instructions. Try a...
Whizzer.
A whizzer. It's a straight power shot that goes directly into the centre of the hole.
Okay, so I'm there. On my loop. On my loop. This is quite lowbrow television. No, but is it, though? Suddenly you get those moments on television. You look around and you think, what are we doing? I'm going out live to the nation. I'm sitting on a loo with a bit of green carpet.
Sometimes I just...
Stupid child putter.
Sometimes I just wish...
Half-wit producer thinks, don't worry, he'll make something out of it.
Sometimes I just wish I could spin the wheel on the Wheel of Fortune.
I really do as well. Mm. OK, are you ready? This is what I'm about to do. Are you ready? It's quite exciting. Hours of fun, isn't it, that? Gosh, I don't think I'll ever take a book in the loo again now. Now I've got this to pep up my loo tump. Look, it just goes over the hole. It's useless. What's the last one? The side seated stroke. The golfer rides.
No, that's not.
That's not the game.
The golfer rides the porcelain putting platform in a.
What?
In a side saddle, sophisticated fashion while perfecting his putt.
Yeah.
Oh, it's like that.
Oh, I see. Mind your back, Johnny. Let me support you.
Okay, just... I wish we'd rehearsed this as well. Have you got all... But I think you're getting all the right shots. Okay, there we go. Ooh! Well, it's just stupid.
All right.
Jen, that's just ridiculous.
It is ridiculous. That really enjoyed.
Do you see that item there? And Jen, I wish there was a flusher as well. So you just go... And say goodbye to us.
In fact, to finish the item, I need to go. Let's go to Premiership New Boys.
Yeah, let's go to Premiership New Boys. Go on, Dan. Off your pot. If this is John Barnes,
Premiership
here we go.
New Boys.
Yes, hello and welcome to Premiership New Boys. Today we ask former England player and Newcastle footballer John Barnes who he rates in the Premiership. Over to you, John.
Hello, I'm John Barnes, and here's my exclusive guide to the best up-and-coming players in the Premiership. The player I've chosen today is Jamie Carragher of my old club, Liverpool.
Hello, my name is Jamie Carragher and I play central defender for Liverpool Football Club.
Jamie has impressed me this year. He's really come on. Started off in midfield and moved to the back.
Well, I started up as a centre-forward, as a schoolboy and that type of thing. I with England under 16s and that from there. I've just gradually gone back to midfield and in the end centre defence. That's happened since I've come here.
It's very strong, very aggressive, and if he gets an opportunity, mainly from set pieces or corners, as he scored on his debut for Liverpool, he will throw his head in.
My full debut at home at Anfield against Aston Villa. First game had started and I got the first goal and we went on to win 3-0. So that was probably the highlight of my career.
OK, John, let's talk about speed.
People questioned his speed at the back. But he's not slow, he can get there, but with his tenacity and his ability to read the game, Jamie has been a credit to Liverpool in that position so far.
What about his skill on the ball?
His ability on the ball is good for a defender. He's composed, he brings the ball out, he can make passes. So the way that Liverpool play really is ideal for a player like Jamie being an ex-midfield player.
And how good is his tackling, John?
His tackling is his biggest strength. He's very aggressive, as Dieter Hamann, one of our players will find out, because he actually injured him in a very fair tackle, I have to say.
It was just a tackle on the byline, really, by the bench, and it was just bouncing. It was inviting for me. It was a bit of a 50-50, and he just dangled his leg in a bit, and he was a bit unlucky. He was off balance a bit, and I went through with it. I had all my balance and went through with the tackle, and unfortunately got a knock. it helped out us, because we went on to win 4-1.
And finally, any more words on Jamie Carragher, John?
Jamie, being an ex-midfield player, is comfortable on the ball, very assured and reliable, doesn't take too many chances, but he knows what he can do with the ball.
I don't know, it's just up to the management, and wherever they see you playing, where they see your best position or for the best for the team, just the way it goes.
That's all from me today. Thanks for watching my guide to the up-and-coming players in the Premiership.
Whoa there! Do you know what, viewers? There's only 30 days left till Christmas. The goose is getting fat, so deck the halls and ponder this. Have you ever wondered why Santa never gets any older? You ever wondered about that?
No.
Have you?
Yeah.
But have you?
No.
Why is Rudolph's nose red? Is there a science to Christmas? Joining me this morning, author of Can Reindeer Fly? The Science of Christmas, Dr. Roger Highfield, ladies and gentlemen.
Hi.
Morning, Doc. Actually, you couldn't sort my back out, could you?
No.
Not your field of...
I'm not that sort of doctor. I used to bounce neutrons off soap bubbles, that's how I say.
Might help.
I've got my doctorate, so...
Could be a start. Okay, now, Roger, as a professor of Christmas, I want you to apply your scientific analysis to my favourite Christmas things. Number one, Rudolph the Reindeer's comedy red nose. Is it real?
It's real. I mean, some people have speculated, is it the cold? Is it because Rudolph's, you know, drinking all that sherry that's left out for Santa? But there's a guy called Odd Halverson who's a professor.
Odd. That's his first name.
Crazy name, crazy guy. University
it's
of...
It's a great name for a baby. What have you called your baby? Odd. Is he just quite odd?
Now, Odd told me that actually he reckons that Rudolph's got a parasitic mite infection of its nose. So, I mean, basically, a reindeer's nose is a really elaborate air conditioning system. It's kind of warming air as it goes into the reindeer, cooling it as it goes out the reindeer. And it's a wonderful environment for bugs to live. So poor old Rudolph's probably got little worms called nematodes, all sorts of larvae, and, you know... Poor old Rudolph's nose is red. That's
okay. So Rudolph, does have a red nose, and that's solved. Okay. Why do all children hate Brussels sprouts?
They were probably designed by evolution this way. They're sensitive to very bitter flavours because when we were out on the African savanna, that was, you know, basically poisonous plants tend to be bitter. The kids who ate the poisonous plants would die. They're not around to tell the tale. And their descendants, and that's us included, when we're born, like sweeter flavours, we like fatty foods, and we dislike bitter flavours. And it's bad news in terms of the Brussels sprout, because those bitter sulphurous flavours, or it's a sort of chemical weapon for the plant, it actually helps fend off cancer for us. So it's quite a good thing to eat, a Brussels sprout.
Anyone here liked Brussels sprouts when they were a child?
No.
When they were a child, what? Rosie?
I've always liked Brussels sprouts.
Yeah, but that's because you like pump value, don't you? Yeah. It is, though, isn't it?
No, I like it when they make me Trump.
Yeah, of course you do. That's why you've always liked Brussels sprouts. Okay. Can science explain...
That's hydrogen sulfide, by the way, when... But sorry, the horrible smell is hydrogen sulfide.
That's so hydrogen
just thought I'd tell you that.
Can science explain the phenomenon of Christmas spirit?
Men exude a chemical, a pheromone in their sweat at greater levels during Christmas, and androstenone and androstenol.
Why?
And
these, why at Christmas?
Well, we're not sure why it is, but it seems to be... It's a chemical that's made by women's breasts, for instance, so they think it's something to do with bonding.
Calm down, Johnny!
It helps get pigs in the right mood.
That's why, farmers, that's why I feel so Christmassy every morning, because Vicky sits with me in the makeup room, and it's very Christmassy in there. Okay, so that's why.
That's why.
So why particularly at Christmas?
Well, it's just a seasonal cycle in this sort of pheromone chemical. In fact, we also tend to eat a bit more at this time of year as well. It seems like there's, in fact, just a couple of days
kind of hibernation thing, but we're getting on layers of fat.
Well, yeah, layers of fat for winter, exactly, yeah.
Okay, is it scientifically possible? This is the one that kind of always got me thinking about Santa. Is it scientifically possible for Santa to deliver all his presents on Christmas Eve?
In a nutshell, yes. I've talked to all sorts of big boffins about this, and that's where the...
And you are a big boffin, right?
That's where the book gets its name, Can Reindeer Fly? But if you talk to Larry Silverberg at Georgia State University, he would tell you that they're probably genetically engineered reindeer that are slightly buoyant. You talk to Ian Stewart, University of Warwick, and those elaborate antlers, they're probably aerodynamically designed.
It's the time.
Okay, the time, right, yeah. Santa's only got Christmas Eve to deliver all those presents. Yeah. There's probably about 8 million households, 800 million households out there, 2 billion kids. There's all sorts of theories about warp drive sleighs, about warping the fabric of space and time to sort of tunnel through a wormhole.
Seriously, come on, scientific answer.
Well, that's it. I mean, you know, if you could actually get a warp drive sleigh, you can get to near light speeds, and that means that even though he's got to travel an average speed of about 1,300 miles per second,
you can't make the night longer. I suppose with the international
deadline. Well, you can a bit, yeah. That's a good point. Yeah, in fact, you've probably got about 48 hours.
Longest night Sandra ever had.
I didn't think of that, actually.
he looked knackered. I wonder if he's always got a rosy glow. Yeah, so international dateline, you got...
That's right, so he's probably got about 48 hours, close to 48 hours and 24 hours, because of the way Earth's rotation, the international dateline. But with the help of warp drive sleigh, genetically engineered reindeer, squids, these are superconducting quantum interference devices, you can actually read the magnetic activity of kids' brains, figure out what they want for Christmas, and then he probably has nanotechnology on the back of his sleigh, because you can't cart billions of tons of presents around. Yeah. To actually pull
That's
molecules.
Another thing I was going to come to.
I knew you were leading me that way, actually, yeah. So I decided to, you know, but basically he's pulling molecules out of the air, assembling them into gifts and so on.
OK.
That's it. Simple, really.
I'd like you to come back again, actually, and we'll really talk about nanotechnology, because it's something I'm quite interested in. A lot of the guys in sound use that.
Okay, nanotechnology and ants. Yeah. You enjoy it.
OK. Don't then. Dr. Roger Highfield, ladies and gentlemen. Right, in a second, we've got vital statistics for you. Meantime, though, this is Channel 4. You're watching The Big Breakfast, where life always starts at 7.
Motion picture event. Liam Neeson, Jeffrey Rush, Uma Thurman, and Claire Danes, Les Miserables.
Renaissance Worldwide Singapore. Musical enlightenment courtesy of David Morales, Dave Seaman, and BT.
Woo! Woo! Look, guys, these shoes here are useless. They're all right for farm work, but for running. A pair of proper trainers like this, maybe your Saturday job or working at the chip shop, put a few quid away, but, you know, save up and get the right shoes, all right? And the socks, you know, if you're a runner, these socks make you look like a clown running down the street. Get some nice proper trainers like these, and I'll tell you what, doesn't hurt with the ladies. You know what I'm saying?
It's the best Disney album yet. All your favourite songs from The Jungle Book, The Little Mermaid, Aladdin, Toy Story, and more. 40 classic Disney songs for the whole family to enjoy this Christmas. The Disney Experience on CD and cassette now.
This Christmas, prepare to journey to another world. They're the screen's smallest heroes in one of the biggest video releases of the year. But make sure that nothing comes between you and your enjoyment of The Borrowers. The Borrowers. Buy it on video.
The biggest 80s hits in the world, ever.
Stay close to me.
Album of the decade.
Do you really want to hurt me?
41 mega hits from the massive 80s. The biggest 80s songs. The biggest 80s superstars. These are the biggest 80s hits in the world ever.
Welcome back to The Big Breakfast.
Do you know what I find often helps if I have a bad back?
What?
Massage balls.
Really?
Yeah.
Those things that look obscene with the big handle and the two balls at the bottom.
Yes.
Yeah, they're funny, those are.
They're really good.
And from funny massage balls...
To...
Go on.
Balls of wisdom.
balls of wisdom.
Goodness gracious.
Yeah, wisdom. Balls of wisdom. Wisdom. Wisdom, wisdom is within the news. No news is good news, but some news is still good.
What a build-up. Good morning. These are the main stories on Friday, the 20th of November. A new designer drug blamed for three deaths. Is it the end of the line for the booze cruise? Shareholders not so united behind Martin Edwards. Police have issued a warning about the potentially lethal effects of a new generation of designer drugs which are flooding Britain's nightclubs. They are said to be more than 30 times stronger than ecstasy. One of the drugs with the street name of Flatliners is known to have killed at least three people. The Prince of Wales is to formally complain about a Mirror newspaper story about Prince Harry. Editor Piers Morgan refused to apologise for the front page story regarding a minor sports injury sustained by the Prince because he wasn't allowed to publish details. Prince Charles has now asked the Press Complaints Commission to deal with it. A two-pronged attack has been launched to stop cheap drink being smuggled into Britain from France. Customs and excise offices are to raid shops, pubs and clubs in a pre-Christmas crackdown called Operation Mistletoe. And supermarkets are beginning to slash their drinks prices so that people won't have to look for bargains across the channel. Children from disadvantaged backgrounds are to benefit from a £540 million scheme launched by the Prime Minister. The Sure Start programme will give advice on health, education and child development in 250 projects over 3 years. It's hoped that the parents of more than 100,000 youngsters will be helped. Health experts in Beijing say that within 50 years, 3 million Chinese men will die every year from smoking-related illnesses. A third of the world's tobacco is smoked in China, yet few people there know about the risks. Here's the sport. Wolves have been inundated with applications for their vacant manager's job. Sadly, Mark McGee is proving hard to replace. The 150 letters received so far include some from detectives, deputy head teachers and two young girls. Manchester United's chief executive, Martin Edwards, has faced calls to resign over the proposed takeover by BSkyB. More than 1,000 shareholders quizzed the board about the bid at the club's annual general meeting. Despite angry scenes on the floor, Edwards believes that most shareholders actually backed the move. Here's the way the weather looks. Temperatures should range from 7 Celsius in London to 11 in Belfast. Rain is likely in Scotland and northwestern regions. It should be dry elsewhere. This morning, expect rain in the north and west. The south, the sun will only make a brief appearance in eastern regions. After lunch, that rain will spread to western areas, while the southeast will see some sun. Here's the five-day forecast. The north will have a wet week with sun on Sunday and Wednesday. Central regions will be cloudy all week with rain on Sunday and Tuesday. And for the south, some sun tomorrow, but cloudy all week, all of next week, with rain on Tuesday and Wednesday. That's the Big Breakfast News at 7:37. Back to Johnny and Denise.
Yay! Yay! Yay!
Thank you, Phil.
Phil Gale, ladies and gentlemen. Yay! Okay, oh, do you know, I can hear a little theme. Farmyards can be dangerous places for the uninitiated. Such was the experience of hapless motorcycle owner Alan Wilson. What's going on down there?
I'm sorry, Johnny.
Alan, an actor researching a role in a new TV drama series, The Farm, parked his Harley Davidson on a Cornish farmyard and went for a stroll around the farm to help his character development. Do you ever go to things like that as an actress?
No.
Okay. Overcome by the strong country air, he started back and was horrified to find a 100-pound pig called Charlton had escaped from his pen and was making passionate advances towards his Harley Davidson. Which is ironic, because they call those hogs, don't they?
Yeah.
I saw what looked like an ugly fat man in a pink jogging suit jump on my bike, said Mr. Wilson, who was most unimpressed by Charlton's athletics. Thank you. Thinking on his feet and reaching into a trough of pig swill, Alan grabbed a large turnip and was about to throw it at Charlton when the irate farmer arrived, shouting, "Get off my land!" Alan seized his only chance and hurled the turnip at Charlton, who flew backwards into the air, giving Alan the chance to save his bacon and his prized bike. Pigs might fly, this one nearly did. We won't tell you any porkies in today's...
Bless it, no!
Look, the other animals just look on in amazement. Look at that. They really admire that pig. If only they had electronic insides, they're thinking. Okay, do you know what? It's time for today's Vital Statistics.
Yeah!
Vital Statistics. Farm.
vital statistics. Get off my land!
Yes, indeed, it's time for today's farm-related vital statistics. You got a pretty mouth, boy. Gonna make you squeal that pig.
Oh, look.
You got a pretty mouth, piggy, little piggy. Little piggy boy.
So sweet.
Okay, turn the pig off. Right, here we go. A bid for freedom that ended.
Oh,
it's okay, it's okay.
Grosh, you misery.
Melandra Burrows looking quite shocked there, weren't you?
Never work with children and animals, that's what you get.
I know, we've got Ben and Bert.
Yeah, we've got Ben and the pig. Okay. Never worked with children and animals, we've got Ben and carpet. Okay, we got.
But they're all my
just,
children.
Just a little joke. Is that all right? Yes. It's not going to affect Cord for the day later, is it?
No, Johnny, it won't.
Yes! Hey! Steps of woe, steps of woe. Steps of woe, steps of woe, cup. Steps of woe. Steps of woe. Because I've got a bad back. Go on.
Oh, it's freezing out there.
Yeah. Oh, yes.
Go!
Freeze! Okay, Dan, what should we shout?
What should we shout? Let's shout,
animal, yes.
Animal.
Squeal like a pig, boy.
No, animal, I think. Animal. You ready?
Okay.
One, two, three.
Animal! There we go. And that is the sort of treatment where that's the sort of iron discipline. Okay, stat one. Number of farmers in the UK who have a brand new combine harvester. How many farmers do you reckon have got a brand new combine harvester?
Got a brand new combine harvester. Yeah.
What do you reckon?
How many? 300.
300. Dr. Rog.
2,000.
Eric. On a farm. The harvester's come back.
1,500.
Do you know what it is? Norfolk, you probably. Have you ever driven a combine?
Yeah, I have.
But only on the road where it really winds people up. I'd have a combine, just take it through Soho. really slowly. Okay. Stat one. Number of. So, do you know what it is? It's 1,148 farmers who've got a brand new combine owners. What if they actually say, yeah, I've got a brand. And they see the irony in that. It's a nice combine. Yeah, I got a brand new combine harvester. No. Will you give me the key? No, I won't. Number of old McDonalds who have a farm in the UK. There are farmers called Old McDonalds. How funny though to be a farmer. If you were an old McDonald who's got a brand new combine harvester, I bet lots of farmers make gags. It just doesn't stop.
Glenn.
Ten.
Think more actually. 15.
15. Mm. Okay. Darren, our pianist.
15. Yeah.
Okay, if you want to do that, that's fine, yeah. We like a variety of numbers. You can pick loads, but you've gone for the same one. Okay. Do you know what? It's actually 32. There's 32 old McDonald's who have a farm in the United Kingdom.
E-I-E-I-O.
E-I-E-I-O. We cry, I caramba!
Caramba!
Caramba, but that's, no. Funnily enough, that's later. Okay, number of sheep in the title sequence of the popular farm drama series Emmerdale, formerly called Emmerdale Farm.
Melandra.
Oh,
they're fancy lambs. They were lambs.
Sheep.
They're lambs. Oh, six. I'm right. I am right. Don't argue with me.
It's 15.
Six.
It's 15.
Six.
Okay.
You're wrong. Who's
How many black
research?
Sheep? How many black sheep?
None.
No, there's one.
There isn't.
There is.
There is not.
There is.
Black face.
No.
Black sheep.
No.
Two with black faces.
No. Number of bar black sheep in the UK. Joy. What do you reckon? How many black sheep do you reckon there are in the UK, in the United Kingdom, as part of the national flock?
I reckon, I don't know what the bar bit means, but 16,000.
I think it's a rubbish joke, I won't worry about that.
16,000.
16,000. I'll tell you now, okay, it's actually 5,107,080 black sheep, Den.
Wow.
I love your farm stats. Total weight of all the wool of all those black sheep.
It's not heavy.
Not like in your day, probably.
Total weight of all
the wool.
50 ounces. 50 ounces per bag. Yeah.
Mad. It's all such an old thing.
He was muttering at a bus stop yesterday. It's all
right. 500,000 kilos.
It's 12,767,700 kilos. You could certainly fill more than three bags of wool with that.
Whoa!
Oh dear. We cry, Rantastico! Okay, stat three. Number of cow pats. One cow produces every day.
12.
Ben, you think five?
No, I think three.
Dan?
Three, not that many, because they kind of let it all go in one drop.
Did he call Dave? Okay, do you know what the answer is? It's 12. Whoa. 12 cow pats a day. I love when you're going past the farm scene, you see a cow let go. I don't know why, it just makes me laugh every time. But if you
should play cow pat chicken.
Chicken.
No, my, lie underneath and then try and dart other
my ones. Trick with farm, have I told you this, about what I do with bags of farm manure?
No, I don't know if I want to know.
Have you ever done this with horse poo?
Oh, no.
And you scoop it off the road, yeah? You whack it in a bag, yeah? And you put it in a bag. Go around to your mate's house, yeah? You go, oh,
you've
do you know
told
what?
Me this.
I had veggie dinner last night. I've been eating with veggie food. Can I use your loo? And you just fill the bowl up with the horse manure. And put a couple of bits of loo paper on top. And you go, it just won't flush. I can't get it down. It's a great trick, and your friend will thank you for it.
I'm sorry if you're eating breakfast this morning.
Okay, that's a good trick, though. It's a good trick. You can do it after football matches. That's when I was, because there was lots of poo about. Number of days it would take a cow to produce enough cow pats to match the body weight of EastEnders' Pat Butcher.
Number of days? I think 3 days.
3 days. No, 14 and a half days. Number of times Pat Butcher has been called a cow in EastEnders?
Well, we know the most recent 14. One was...
Yeah, and there was cow. 60 over there, lots of numbers coming in. I'll tell you now.
I think it's only about five times. It's quite strong in EastEnders terms, isn't it, to say that?
What, car?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, it is. When they call you a car, that's
yeah,
a bad
that's,
one.
That's bad.
Have you ever been called a car?
Many times.
Have you?
Yeah.
Who's the last person to call you a car?
I can't remember.
Okay. Number of times Pat Butcher's been called a cow in EastEnders.
Peggy Mitchell.
187.
No way.
187 times throughout the series. We cried, Bellissimo! And that's the end of today's farm-related vital statistics with the special set there.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you, Ben, for displaying that all
Thank you. It's a good display, Ben. You did that very quickly. It was good work.
OK, coming up after the break, the best of Britain's young vocal talents in Pushy Dad.
Pushy Dad. Yay!
But right now, this is Channel 4. You're watching The Big Breakfast, where live starts at 7 on the farm.
It certainly does, Dan.
You know you want it.
Love can touch us one time and last for.
The All Time Greatest Love Songs, Volume 3.
Can feel the love.
The greatest stars with the greatest love songs. And this, the number one hit of the year. Get the all-time greatest love songs, Volume 3.
You'll never forget her sense of wonder, her dream of adventure.
Ariel!
You'll never forget the first time you experienced the magic. Now, Walt Disney Classics' most requested film, The Little Mermaid, is back on video.
Isn't this great?
Spectacular!
But she won't be around forever.
I gotta go!
So hurry! Walt Disney's full-length feature, The Little Mermaid. Catch her before she swims away.
Ladies and gentlemen, the best of George Michael double CD at Woolies for $16.99.
First,
it's that time of the week when we say, here's looking at you, kid. Yes, another mini megastar is about to be thrust into the limelight by her persistent parent. This week, though, it's a pushy dad.
Go on, darling. Do it for...
Daddy.
There we go. Was that me doing the daddy?
Yeah.
Didn't I do that? That's me. Good. Okay, I'm just unaware of what I've ever done. So please welcome to the house Fintan and Rochelle O'Rourke, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, so Fintan, you're this week's pushiest parent,
absolutely.
In this case. What made you decide to barge your way onto the Big Breakfast?
Well, first of all, countless phone calls, lots of emails down to the Big Breakfast.
Good use of the latest technology,
yeah,
that's nice.
Absolutely. And then coming all the way down from Teesside personally as well to just really, really get on people's nerves and say, look,
you actually
on,
made a personal visit down. Oh,
absolutely, yeah. All the way down just to make sure we got restored.
Where did you come? Did you come to here or did you go to the Big Breakfast offices?
Planet 24, yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
Isn't that amazing? All the way down from Teesside. It's about a four-hour journey, five-hour journey.
Yeah, definitely. Oh, it's worth it, though, isn't it?
Yeah, it is worth it. Of course it is.
And in the end, bouquet of flowers, chocolates.
Again, gifts, visit, email, letters. Yeah. Beautiful. How long was the campaign in all?
Oh, 6 months, possibly more.
Isn't that fantastic? But don't be put off. Don't be put off. It's just what you got to do. Okay. Now, you market your daughter very carefully. Why have you chosen the Big Breakfast?
It's just a great platform, really, for children to, you know, to come onto TV. If you can follow in the shadows of the likes of All Saints, Bewitched, what better platform can you get?
Cleopatra as well, of course.
Yeah, absolutely.
The latest ones. Absolutely right. We make stars virtually every week. And they rarely show any gratitude. OK. So what has Rochelle got to show for all that kind of pushiness?
Well, I make her do singing lessons every week, 3 hours a week.
That's good. Yeah. Good use of word, mate. Nice, nice. Even the piano player looking excited about that.
She has to write a song every fortnight.
Write a song?
Yeah, she writes songs, does all sorts of things.
Because you don't want her to be reliant on other songwriters. She's got to generate her own material.
Absolutely. Well, talent's creativity as well as being able to do it as well, so we really push that. She gets dance and drama lessons on Saturdays as well, so probably most of the week she's doing something which, you know, is down to success and helping out in the future.
Okay. Does she have much of a social life? I hope not.
It's all about singing and entertainment.
Absolutely right. Exactly. She'll be able to socialise when she's rich and famous with lots of glamorous people.
I want to socialise with her.
Yeah. Exactly right. Again, pushing me on the future, which hasn't happened yet. Do you like that? It's a lovely touch.
But it's going to.
Okay, it's a great outfit. Did you choose the outfit?
No, I did. My dad did.
Your dad chose the outfit? Do you find him very pushy indeed?
Yes, he's very pushy.
Oh, fantastic. It's lovely to hear her say it as well. It's lovely. Yeah. Okay, what are you going to perform for us today, Rochelle?
I'm going to perform How Do I Live.
How Do You Live? Oh, the classic Celine, is it Celine Dion?
Leanne
Rimes. So, yeah, fantastic. And were you delighted when you heard you were going to be on The Big Breakfast? I normally ask you're absolutely thrilled. Was she absolutely thrilled?
Oh, she's just over the moon.
Dancing around the house?
Yeah, phone calls, left, right and centre.
But was she as delighted as you?
No, I was more delighted.
Though. Good, that's the way it should be, ladies and gentlemen. Rochelle, here we go.
How do I get through without you? If I had to leave without you, what kind of life would that be? Oh, why? I need you in my arms, need you to hold. You're my world, my heart, my soul. If you ever be no other for me, and I, baby, I don't know what I would do. I'd be lost if I lost you. If you ever leave, baby, you would take away everything good in my life. And tell me now, how do I live without you?
story tells you try again to get on this slot of the show. It is Pushy Mother, the Big Breakfast, two Lockkeepers Colleges. Oh. Old Ford Lock, London. Email, send videotape, send audio tapes, write, fax, do what you can, cash.
Oh,
Vaughny likes a bun. I'll tell you that. There's no bungs involved, just pure talent. Thank you very much indeed, Rochelle. This is Channel 4. You're watching The Big Breakfast, where life starts at 7 hours.
Whoever you're buying for this Christmas, our price have the perfect gift. You'll find Another Level, the album, for only $12.99. It includes the number one single, Freak Me. Plus, Be Alone No More. And the current single, Guess I Was a Fool.
Gifts for all sorts, at our price.
I shall be giving you your presents this year with a touch of magic. A Sainsbury's aromatherapy kit for Auntie Vi.
Pour in your bath, dear, not down your throat.
For Gran from Sainsbury's, the Titanic video. Remember, dear, you were on it. And a Hydro Source bath set for Cousin Raquel. For Sharon, a Santa face bag. For young Paul, a Sainsbury's chocolate drawing kit. And for Uncle Jack, Belgian mint truffles. Belgian mint. Would you like a rabbit?
Sainsbury's. Hundreds of great Christmas gifts from as little as 99p.
Emma, the star of the television series Lakesiders. Now she makes her dream come true with the release of her beautiful debut album, Emma. Never fall in love again. A collection of 12 of the finest love songs. Including the singles I'll Never Fall in Love Again and It May Be Winter Outside. Emma, the debut album, out now.
First, I'm Johnny Vaughan. This is, of course,
Denise Van Outen.
Oh, the very words cause me to shiver with excitement.
Okay. Here's what's still to come on this morning's show. Hold it down.
Okay, hold it down. Yeah, at 8:03, what the paper Brit in our paper review, ladies and gentlemen.
And then at 8:15, we revealed the delights of the pun of the week with the lovely Cockney Vic.
Are you that way? Okay, at 8:20, Emmerdale Super Babe.
Melandra Burrows.
Melandra Burrows is in the house, ladies.
Is it Melandra? How about that? Melandra. What? How do you pronounce?
Oh, don't be posh, Denise.
Come on, what you got, chat mob?
I'll just call you Mal.
Mal.
Yes. Okay.
Okay, but right now it is time.
No,
for...
No, what do you like it to be pronounced as? That's all we're asking. Is it Melandra?
Oh, dropping.
Yes, it's just guest etiquette.
Not a morning person.
Is it Melandra or Melandra? Mal.
Melandra.
Melandra.
Why are you being all posh?
We're not being that. I just want to get the pronunciation right. I just want to get it right. We don't know if he likes being called David, but we call him Dave.
David!
We have a very special occasion 757 for you this morning, because you know Melanie Blatch from All Saints is practically giving birth. So we're going to have an All Saints special.
I can't believe they wouldn't allow us the old B there. As soon as we made it.